If you've ever been confused by your cat's subtle cues or struggled to set boundaries, you're not alone. In this video, we will explore the complex language of cats and explain how to say no in a way your cat understands. By the end of this presentation, you will have gained valuable insights on interpreting your cat's signals, strengthening your bond, and developing a harmonious relationship. We recommend you take notes as you explore practical techniques to decipher your cat's language and enrich your bond. If you have your own experiences and comments, please share them with us in our community. These techniques will definitely help you understand your cat better. Understanding cat communication. 1. Decoding cat body language. Before we discuss how to say no to your cat, let's examine how our feline friends communicate. Cats rely heavily on subtle cues to convey their emotions and intentions, making them masters of nonverbal communication. Understanding these signals is crucial for building a strong bond with your cat and effectively meeting their needs. One of the main ways cats communicate is through their body language. Pay close attention to their ears, tail, and posture to gauge their mood. For example, when a cat holds its ears forward, it's showing curiosity or friendliness. On the other hand, flattened ears mean fear or aggression. A relaxed and erect tail indicates contentment, while an inflated tail indicates agitation or fear. In addition, a cat's posture can reveal a lot about how they feel. A relaxed and open posture indicates comfort, while a tense or hunched posture can indicate stress or discomfort. Besides body language, cats also use their voices to communicate with humans and other animals. Cats have a wide variety of meows, each serving a different purpose. A short, high-pitched meow can be a greeting or a request for attention, while a low, long meow can indicate dissatisfaction or discomfort. To better understand your cat's needs and wants, pay attention to the tone, pitch, and frequency of their vocalizations. Now use this understanding of cat communication. 2. Recognizing stress signals. Cats are sensitive creatures and may show signs of stress when overwhelmed or anxious. It is important for cat owners to recognize these signals to ensure their cat friends are healthy and happy. One common indicator of stress in cats is flattened ears, which typically signal discomfort or fear. This may be due to loud noises, unfamiliar surroundings, or interactions with other pets or people. Dilated pupils are a sign of stress in cats. Pupil dilation can occur naturally in low light or during moments of excitement. However, excessively dilated pupils, especially in well-lit environments, may indicate heightened arousal or anxiety. Cats may also blink rapidly or squint in conjunction with dilated pupils, further indicating their discomfort. A twitching tail may indicate that your cat is feeling stressed. While some tail twitching is normal during moments of excitement or concentration, excessive twitching or thrashing can signal agitation or frustration. To accurately gauge your cat's emotional state, pay attention to the speed and intensity of their tail movements. Understanding these subtle signals can help cat owners address their pet's needs and prevent potential conflicts. To alleviate your cat's stress and ensure a harmonious relationship, create a calm and supportive environment. Provide opportunities for play and relaxation, and respect their boundaries. Let's now explore effective ways to communicate boundaries and say no to your cat in a language they'll understand. 3. Interpreting vocalizations. Cats communicate with their human companions and other animals through body language and vocalizations. Other vocalizations, such as purrs and yowls, also carry unique meanings that provide valuable insights into a cat's state of mind and desires. Meows are the most well-known vocalization used by cats, conveying a wide range of emotions and intentions depending on their tone, pitch, and duration. A short, high-pitched meow may indicate excitement or a greeting, while a long, drawn-out meow could signify frustration or a request for attention. Purring is another common vocalization used by cats, often associated with contentment and relaxation. Cats use different vocalizations to communicate various emotions. However, cats may also purr when they're in pain or distress, so it's essential to consider the context in which the purring occurs. Chirps, trills, and chirrups are vocalizations that cats use to communicate with each other and their human companions. These sounds are often used as a form of greeting or to express affection. Paying attention to the frequency and intensity of these vocalizations can help you better understand your cat's mood and respond accordingly. By tuning into your cat's vocalizations and observing their body language, you can develop a deeper understanding of their needs and preferences. Understanding your cat's vocal cues can strengthen your bond and enhance communication. Here are some effective ways to communicate boundaries and say no to your cat in their own language, ensuring a harmonious relationship based on mutual understanding and respect. How to say no in cat language. 4. Establishing boundaries. Just like humans, cats require boundaries to feel secure in their environment. When your cat exhibits undesirable behavior, such as scratching furniture or jumping on countertops, it is crucial to communicate your disapproval effectively. 5, using hissing or growling. Hissing or growling can be effective ways to communicate disapproval to your cat. These sounds mimic the warnings cats use in the wild to deter threats. When a cat hisses or growls, it's typically a sign that they feel threatened, scared, or upset. By emitting these sounds, cats express their discomfort and signal to others to back off. When communicating boundaries to your cat, hissing or growling can assert your authority and discourage undesirable behavior. Emitting a hiss or growl when your cat engages in unwanted behavior, such as scratching furniture or entering forbidden areas, can convey your disapproval. However, it's important to use these vocalizations sparingly and only when necessary. While hissing or growling can be effective deterrents, using them excessively or inappropriately can lead to fear or aggression in your cat. Your cat may associate these sounds with negative experiences over time, causing them to become anxious or defensive in your presence. Instead, reserve hissing or growling for moments when your cat's behavior warrants a strong deterrent. Combine these vocalizations with positive reinforcement techniques, such as redirecting your cat's attention to more appropriate activities or providing rewards for desirable behavior. This approach helps to maintain a balanced and respectful relationship with your cat, where boundaries are communicated effectively without instilling fear or hostility. Effective communication with your cat involves more than just vocalizations. To understand your cat's needs, pay attention to their body language, tone of voice, and overall demeanor. By respecting your cat's boundaries and using gentle yet assertive communication techniques, you can foster a trusting and harmonious relationship with your feline companion. 6. Redirecting behavior. Rather than just saying no, redirect your cat's attention to a more suitable activity. Offer them a scratching post or interactive toy to fulfill their natural instincts. Positive reinforcement promotes good behavior while reducing conflict, enhancing your bond. 7. Building trust through positive reinforcement. Positive reinforcement is essential for strengthening the bond with your cat. When your cat exhibits desirable behavior, such as using their scratching post or litter box, reward them with praise or treats. This encourages them to repeat the behavior in the future. 8. Creating a safe environment. To ensure your cat's well-being, it is crucial to provide a safe and stimulating environment that offers ample opportunities for play, exploration, and rest. By meeting your cat's physical and emotional needs, you can foster a strong and trusting relationship. By understanding the subtle nuances of cat communication and applying gentle yet effective techniques, you can say no to your cat while deepening your bond. Approach communication with your feline companion with patience, empathy, and respect. Listen attentively to your cat's cues, both verbal and nonverbal, to accurately decipher their needs and desires. By paying close attention to your cat's body language, vocalizations, and behaviors, you can gain valuable insights into their emotional state and respond accordingly. It is paramount to respect your cat's boundaries to build a trusting and harmonious relationship. Just as humans appreciate having their personal space respected, cats also require boundaries to feel secure and valued. Be mindful of your cat's comfort levels and avoid pushing them beyond their limits. Building a relationship based on trust and understanding is crucial to developing a strong bond with your cat. Consistently showing care, empathy, and affection can create a supportive environment where your cat feels comfortable expressing themselves freely. Thank you for joining us on this captivating journey into the fascinating world of cat language. We hope you have gained valuable insights and practical tips for enhancing your communication with your furry friend. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more informative content on understanding and connecting with our beloved feline companions. Until next time, happy communicating!